My connection to Jogen Chowdhury has been really as a viewer, as an admirer of his work, and as someone who's written about his work now for really about 30 years.
এখানে যত কিছু ছবি আছে, whatever artworks are here, you see, they contain, you know, our people, our society, my environment, everything, you know, is there. So this is what I feel is interesting.
I would like viewers to be able to look at the 175 works that we have here and to be surprised, because many, many people, of course, know Jogen Chowdhury's work very well.
So this is what is interesting. When I look at my own work, I find that most of the works is related to people, society, and various condition of life.
When we were working on this exhibition, what I really wanted to do was to bear witness to the versatility of Jogendra's artistic practice.
You know, black is very dominating in my work. The reason was, during, you know, my early life, when I was a student of College of Art, we had no light in our house. So I used to work with hurricane lamp. I was sitting with my brother and sister, and I was working on a sketchbook, drawing them or the surroundings around them, you know, with hurricane lamp. And that time I could not do anything else without using black ink. I also see that it is not only the ink, that atmosphere, but also the social atmosphere also was very depressing. The Calcutta during that time, due to that refugee problem, we were really in difficult situation throughout that particular period, and that also was a sense of depression, sense of darkness, which continued to stay even my present work, even though this time has changed. But I could not stop using black since then. Even today, if I work something, the black dominates my work.
What I've tried to do in the exhibition, in designing it spatially as well as its thematic emphases, is to create a set of focal points. The artist as storyteller, the artist as someone who's been preoccupied with the human figure and with the couple, his understanding of the cycle of life, his understanding of how opposites come together, whether it's line and color or abstraction and the figure, and of course, his deep roots in several pedagogical institutions.
I also enjoy even looking to the people, you know, in the street. You know, from my car, I see someone passing by and then having interesting, you know, dress or some expression or some attitude, you know, which interests me. So I think that in my work also, you can find varieties of expression.
For me, what compels fascination in Jogendra's work is how it manages to make one medium seem like another. So when he's using dry pastel, for instance, it seems as though we're looking at the work of an engraver or a lithographer. When we look at his serigraphs, it seems that we're looking at someone who is a master of ink and wash technique. The magic and the enchantment that Jogen Chowdhury exercises, no matter what medium he touches, he transforms it. And it's that transformative energy that I hope this exhibition communicates.
The Emami art and this center for creativity is something unique in Calcutta now. Not only in Calcutta, probably this is the only institution now in whole India which is so meticulously designed and is working for art. So I think that I am also very happy for this show, you know, for this display, for the people who are here, you know, helping us, and particularly Richa and her team in this exhibition is, I must remember their, you know, association, how we have created this exhibition. So I thank all of them. So we'll remember, I mean, rest of my life, how the exhibition is being held here. So thank you, everybody.